He's fighting a very intelligent fight. He takes a swift left hand to the right hook for Pacquiao and sees him jump on retaliating. This has the makings of being a very interesting fight. Momentarily shocked Oscar. You see what surprised me, and it's been definitely close to Pacquiao fight. So a little left hand lead of Manny's is an issue right now. Even though dangerous and destructive, likely a 1-0-2. Jab, jab, straight left hand. His ability to fashion the first hand, or the lead left hand, starting his offense with it, as he's out there, shows how much he's progressed as a tactician. One thing that you mean is very obvious. Oscar De La Hoya has very little head movement.
There is only almost no height difference between
them. And that is a brilliant uppercut. And he came in
to land something. You have to believe that.
He just landed a good left hook to the body, built his back against it. There is a quick stomach outside the left eye of Oscar De La Hoya. The right hand has never been a super destructive box for De La Hoya. I asked Freddie Rhodes yesterday, and I said, have you ever seen Oscar De La Hoya really hurt somebody with the right hand?
And if Oscar's not going to move his head at him so much, and even if he doesn't have his ass, keep pumping him. But he doesn't jab enough.
Good body shots there by Pacquiao. And there was doubt coming in as to whether Pacquiao could.
Right down the pipe. So that's the kind of punches going to bend it down.
Sure, you would think against the so-called smaller man, you'd see something more.
This fight's going to come in about this time. Manny Pacquiao is annihilating Oscar De La Hoya.
He's looking at Charlie Oscar.
De La Hoya hasn't been down, but that may be the only thing that's
punch, and it's not so much that the way standing the body language and position of De La Hoya's body is as a man that's defeated.
All right, Larry, you had mentioned this one. Did you see Pacquiao against Margarito?
No, and he himself says he's going back to 140.